Chemistry is known as the central science, and students who major in chemistry will leave college with knowledge in advanced mathematics and science concepts. As a chemistry major, you take a combination of advanced math and science courses, and primarily during your time in lab, you will develop the technical and analytical skills required for your future career. As well as developing excellent laboratory techniques, you gain specific knowledge in traditional fields of chemistry. Because chemistry overlaps with many other subjects, you will also pick up skills that are useful in biology and medicine, physics and engineering, and geology and earth science. As you progress through your college career, you'll want to be mindful of the skills you are refining by majoring in chemistry. As well as developing a strong mathematical and numerical ability, you will also need to develop and refine the following skills: analysis and problem solving, time management and organization, written and oral communication, monitoring and maintaining records and data, teamwork, research and presentation, and IT and technology. There are many career paths that chemists can take, but some of the jobs directly related to a chemistry degree are analytical chemist, chemical engineer, healthcare scientist and clinical biochemistry, forensic scientist, pharmacologist, research scientist, toxicologist, and medical and clinical laboratory technician. Later in the video, we will go into a few of these in more detail, but you can use this as a starting point for what you would like to do with your chemistry major. One of the easiest ways to begin your career as a chemist is by taking a job as a laboratory technician. This is a way for young professionals to start at the bottom of a company and work their way up with senior positions, generally requiring a master's or PhD. Furthermore, depending on your company, you might even be able to be paid to go back to school so that you can earn a graduate school degree and move up in the company. Lab techs are needed in a range of sectors, including but not limited to medical, clinical research, biotech, and environmental lab tech positions. Lab technicians are skilled workers that work with complex systems or perform highly technical, mechanical, or diagnostic tests in medical or scientific laboratories. Clinical and medical lab technicians are the two most common areas of work for lab techs. Much of your individual training will be learned on the job, but you will have a foundation of laboratory skills from your time in lab during undergrad. For example, if you were a medical laboratory technician, the tests you would be running would be ordered for the patients and are based on recommendations from doctors and other healthcare providers. Lab technicians usually have no direct interaction with the patients, but rather perform tests on human bodily fluids, tissue samples, and cells collected by nurses or other healthcare professionals to determine diagnoses and identify abnormalities. As a technician, you would then use microscopes, computers, and automated laboratory equipment, as well as keep detailed records of the data you compile. In May 2015, the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics reported an annual median salary of $38,970 for medical and clinical laboratory technicians. The Bureau of Labor Statistics predicts 18% employment growth for these technicians from 2014 to 2024, which is much faster than average. Another job you can take is as an entry-level chemist. Entry-level chemistry jobs will often consist of working individually and as a team member to hypothesize, test, and draw conclusions. They may collaborate with people who specialize in other science-related fields, and especially in today's world, utilize the computing power available to help where applicable. For example, here's a job posting from Indeed.com for an entry-level chemistry position. One thing that I want to draw your attention to is the job requirements. What you'll notice in almost all chemistry job postings is that every company will require some amount of laboratory experience. In order to fulfill this criteria, you will want to find internships either at your university or a private company so that you can develop these skills before you graduate. The average starting salary for chemists will vary by region, but as of 2010, the median entry-level salary was $44,000. Many people who major in chemistry continue on in their education to earn a master's or PhD because this is really where most of the job opportunities present themselves. One of the benefits of attending a PhD program is that you can usually get a good chunk of your education paid for by the university, if not all of it, in exchange for your time spent conducting research underneath a presiding postdoc. This is one way that top research universities like Stanford, MIT, UC Berkeley, and UCLA attract graduate students to attend their universities. You help the university develop new research, and they give you your education and eventually your graduate school diploma. Now, when it comes to being an analytical chemist, although you will be able to find some entry-level jobs, most of them will require a master's or PhD, with the most job opportunity and upward mobility to those with PhDs. Analytical chemists use a diverse range of methods to investigate the chemical nature of substances. The aim is to identify and understand the substance and how it behaves in different conditions. In the pharmaceutical industry, for example, you would be involved throughout the drug development process. This would include studying the physical or chemical properties of drug substances and formulations with a view to determining the quality and stability of drug products. Analytical chemists can find work in a range of scientific industries, and typical employers include agrochemical companies, biotechnology or contract research organizations, chemical and polymer manufacturers, environmental agencies, food companies, government agencies, hospital laboratories, petrochemical companies, pharmaceutical companies, and public health laboratories. And within these industries, analytical chemists' work may be carried out in areas as diverse as drug formulation and development, chemical or forensic analysis, process development, product validation, quality control, and toxicology. Analytical chemists earn an average of $71,700 annually. The highest 10% make around $120,600, while the lowest 10% earned around $41,000. Most analytical chemists work for private research and development firms, but as mentioned previously, many of them can be found at pharmaceutical companies. Other jobs that were not specifically mentioned are agrochemists, biochemists, inorganic chemists, and many more. For example, as an agrochemist, you would combine chemistry and biochemistry knowledge to improve agricultural practices, like improved crop production, or making the process of taking raw goods and turning them into consumable foods and beverages. In a job as a chemist at a food or beverage company, you would likely implement techniques to improve quality assurance and quality control. An inorganic chemist would look at the structure and behavior of inorganic molecules, and this knowledge can be used in mining, geosciences, and the production of semiconductors. Now, a major challenge that new graduates face is landing their first job, and it usually comes down to that they fail to build their resume and build the proper relationships with people in their field to land a job. If you want to become a successful chemist, here are some helpful tips. First off, study hard. Study with students smarter or more talented than you. Although it might be challenging, it will greatly serve you in the long run. Then build relationships with your professors by visiting them during office hours. Join your school's American Chemical Society Club, or hold an office for that club if you can. Interview working chemists as suggested above. Join an established lab with plenty of grad students to conduct your undergraduate research. Observe the grad students and pick their brains when it comes to advanced lab techniques. Get your name on a publication or two. Seek an internship at a private company over the summer or during the school year if you can make it fit while you're in school. TA for a professor or see if there's research opportunities on your campus. If there's a career services department at your school, use it to extend your network and build relationships with potential employers. Attend an on-campus career fair. If you follow everything listed above, you're sure to have a leg up on the competition and almost guaranteed to land a chemistry-related job after a little bit of researching. You will develop valuable skills that companies will be more than willing to pay you for, but by far the most important thing you can do is build your career network. In addition to technical skills, you will also want to consistently improve your interpersonal communication skills. As a chemist, you will require creativity, interpersonal communication skills, which can be simplified to the ability to communicate clearly and concisely, self-confidence and motivation to investigate and solve complex problems, patience, and attention to detail. Outside of the careers listed, chemistry majors can move on to work in sales roles, do some sort of science-related consulting, teach, and many more. The challenge with these careers is that you have to be a little more creative in your job hunt and make the most of your social network. Overall, the chemistry major can lead to many great careers, and one thing that new grads can do to make their job search easier and more productive is to approach it from a project perspective. Avoid wasting time by developing a search plan and not just a resume. There are many different job sectors that chemistry majors fit into, and it is important for you to do your research and identify your interests as soon as possible. If you like this video, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you all next time.